Hi students, now we are going to discuss about the Constituent Assembly and Drafting Committee. See, as we discussed earlier, in order to make a constitution or frame a constitution, you should have a Constituent Assembly and in which you have members who are elected. And we have got 22 committees in this, but why we are discussing only about Drafting Committee, it is very important, which I will tell you later. Constituent Assembly. The Constituent Assembly has formulated the Constitution of India. The members of the Constituent Assembly are elected by the people. And the total membership of Constituent Assembly was 389. See, this, in order to make, see, making constitution is not that easy. Just for making notes will take days and days. See, you have to cater to the needs of all the diverse people in our country. And nobody should get something against them. You have to consider everybody's interest and incorporate in one single document. That is a very Herculean and big task. So that task was given to this Constituent Assembly, and the members of this assembly were elected. And the total membership was 389 of this Constituent Assembly. The Constituent Assembly appointed 22 committees to frame the constitution. Some of the members who written the constitution are, or who are the members of this constitution, I can say, Jawaharlal Nehru, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Rajendra Prasad, Sarojini Naidu, Maulana Azad, etc. Further, I am going to discuss about the major committees. See, though we are having 22 committees in this, some of the major committees of the Constituent Assembly and which have been headed by whom? Name of the committee is like Union Powers Committee and Union Constitution Committee was headed by Jawaharlal Nehru along with States Committee. And Provincial Constitution Committee was headed by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and Drafting Committee, which is the very important committee in the whole, was headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. And Fundamental Rights Subcommittee was headed by J.B. Kripalani, and Minority Subcommittee was headed by H.C. Mukherjee. And Gopinath Bardoloi headed Tribal Area Subcommittee, and A.V. Thakkar headed this Excluded Area Subcommittee. And Rules of Procedure Committee was headed by Rajendra Prasad, who was also the chairman of this Constituent Assembly at the time. And States Committee, as I mentioned earlier, was headed by Jawaharlal Nehru, and Steering Committee was headed by Rajendra Prasad. And Advisory Committee was headed by Vallabhbhai Patel. See, every committee what I mentioned has to do something in their own domain. For example, if I say Finance Committee, all matters related to finance was there in that. And the head, whoever is given this post, is responsible for gathering the information and discussing and putting forth in the Drafting Committee. Now, let's discuss about the Drafting Committee. The Constituent Assembly set up with Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as its chairman. Okay, the Assembly has set up the Drafting Committee, and whose chairman was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Along with that, there it has got so many members such as B.L. Mitter, N. Gopalaswamy Iyengar, Syed Mohammed Sadullah, Dr. K.M. Munshi, Sir Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer, Dr. Deepak Haitan were its members. See, each one of these members were expertised in some or the other area. It's not like, you know, by randomly, by lottery, they picked it. See, they are experts in their own area, some in business, some in judiciary, like that. Later, N. Madhavrao was nominated by the president. Further, with the death of D.P. Khaitan, eminent legal luminary Sri T.T. Krishnamachari was made in his place. See what happened when somebody is assigned with some job, all of a sudden due to some reason, a person or member was died, like D.P. Khaitan. In his place immediately, they had their list with them. In case if somebody is not there, who is going to take his place? Like that, in the place of D.P. Khaitan, eminent legal luminary is a great advocate and justice like T.T. Krishnamachari from Tamil Nadu, is basically from Madras State at that time. He was made in his place. Bengal Narasimha was the chief constitutional advisor to the committee. To this drafting committee, Bengal Narasimha was the chief constitutional advisor. Means anything related to the constitution, if they are going out of the box or something, he will be guiding through his advisors. The Constituent Assembly drafted the constitution and circulated to it for public discussion in February 1948. See, they have sent it to the people various times. They drafted a draft After that, it was sent to the public. First time they sent it for public discussion in February 1948. Again, upon getting the information from them and some changes, modifications, suggestions, they changed and incorporated. Again, it was sent for the public discussion. This is how it has taken 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to come to a shape. As a result, 7,635 amendments were proposed, out of which 2,473 amendments were accepted. See, when they left to the public domain, people are free to express themselves upon this document. Like that, 7,635 amendments were proposed from the public domain. In that, 2,473 amendments were accepted. Okay. After careful consideration of the draft between November 14, 1949 to November 26, 1949, the Constitution of India was adopted on November 1949. Finally, the Constitution of India came into existence from 26 January 1950. As you all know, that day, from which day the Constitution has come into force, we celebrate as a Republic Day. This is for this topic. Now, let's move on to the sources of the Indian Constitution. See, it's the bulkiest constitution, you know, we are discussing about this as a bulkiest constitution. But from where we have got the sources to incorporate, so many provisions we have put in, okay. So, from where we have sourced the information or the provisions, that is what we are going to discuss through this topic now. Sources of the Indian Constitution. Indian Constitution was prepared on the basis of several sources. It incorporated several features of the prominent constitution of the world. While drawing best features of other constitutions, Indian constitution makers adopted only those which are suitable to Indian domestic conditions and avoided unfavorable features. See, you all people know what is a filter. I want to take an example of filter here now. While preparing a tea, what do? The tea leaves, in order to filter them, you keep a filter. Understand? Just like that, even when we have taken all the information provisions from different constitutions of the world, we have filtered so that it suits to our culture, our country and our things. Understand? Like that. The important sources and influences on Indian Constitution include the following. Number one, Government of India Acts of 1919 and 1935 were used and certain elements were considered. As we discussed in our previous topics and all, Government of India Acts of 1919 and 1935, there were certain provisions there of those acts. We have taken directly from them, which suits our country, even after post-independence era, and we have incorporated in the Constitution. In all matters of parliamentary traditions, rule of law, cabinet government, legislative-executive relations, single citizenship and nominal executive, etc., we have followed the Westminster model of British Constitution. Understand? See, British follows the Westminster model, which is known as a place of their Prime Minister. That model, whatever things they have adopted, we have taken, just like a parliament, rule of parliamentary tradition, rule of law and cabinet government. These provisions have been taken from our Westminster's model. Further, when we are discussing about the sources, provisions relating to fundamental rights, judicial review, impeachment of the president, etc. are drawn from the American Constitution. See, from each constitution, something which suits to our country, like that, like assorted sweet dish, we made it. Okay. The important provisions such as fundamental rights, judicial review and impeachment of the president, etc. they have been drawn from the American Constitution. Some items like directive principles of state policy are drawn from the Ireland Constitution. We have drawn so many other things. One among them is directive principles of state policy, which we have taken from Irish Constitution, Constitution of the Ireland. Some of the emergency provisions of the president are drawn from the Constitution of Germany. See, Germany Constitution is known also as Weimar Constitution. We have taken the emergency provisions, meaning because if something happens to a country in an emergency, how it has to deal with. Such provisions we have taken from whom? From the Weimar Constitution of Germany. Matters such as concurrent list, trade and commerce and transport, joint sitting of parliament, etc. were included on the model of Australian Constitution. See, something of federal nature. Federal nature means related to the union and the states. Okay, such kind of concurrent list, trade and commerce among the within the states and between the states, like that. Such things are taken from the Australian Constitution. The operating clause of right to life and liberty, procedure established by law, drawn from the Japanese constitution. As you all know, Japanese people give more importance to the peace and all. So, and also the rights, right to life and rights of citizens and the rule of law or procedure established by law. Such kinds of things were taken by in the Japanese constitution. And the 8-point federal structure with powerful center of Indian constitution is designed basing on the constitution of Canada. Canada is having a very great federal structure. You have a powerful union and a similar states as well. So such a kind of political structure was taken from Canada. Okay, I mean in the sense constitution of Canada has given those provisions. The provisions relating to the procedure to amend the constitution are based on South African constitution. This is very important provision because see we made some document because we did not since around 200 years we have been ruled by the Britishers and we have given a chance to rule yourself. But we made a book or rule book which is going to last for 100 years or 200 years. But we have to change accordingly, no? In such sense, amendment, provision of amendment is important. Understand? Just like I'll tell you one example. A building is built on an open land. You have seen, observed sometimes, on the terrace, they leave some structure or continuation for your, what is that? Pillar structure, raw pillar structure is left like that. Because in case you want to make any changes, accordingly you can make in future. Such provision is this amendment procedure, which we have drawn from South African constitution. This is under Article 368. The idea of republic and the ideals of liberty, equality and fraternity are drawn based on the constitution of France. See, peace-loving people of France, like they have the political or democratic ideas such as liberty, equality and fraternity. They have been drawn from the constitution of France. Further, as several provisions of the Indian constitution are drawn based on the constitution of other countries, it is criticized as a bundle of borrowings. See, there are always critics for everything, but it should also be there because we have drawn everything from different constitutions. Some critics discussed or criticized the constitution as it's a just bundle of borrowings, as if we borrowed everything from different constitutions and we don't have anything on our own. But the constitution makers have molded the provisions for the other constitutions to suit the Indian socio-economic and political conditions. Means we have not taken something like this. Our constitutional experts, they have put lot of efforts. See, making something from scratch, it is very easy. Why? Because directly you can make it. But something you take and mold it according to your, to suit your needs, that is difficult thing. That has been done by our constitutional experts. Though they have borrowed something from other countries' constitutions, but they have modified it in order to suit the diverse interest of our country. In view of its length and comprehension, Indian constitution is also described as elephantine constitution. See, there are always critics and we should also have critics to criticize the things because that's how we are going to change ourselves, understand? Because of its bulkiest constitution, being bulkiest in the world, it has been named as elephantine constitution. Thank you.